Hello students, now we will see how to isolate the bacteriophages from the sewage sample. So before going into the procedure, let us know what are the requirements for this experiment. So first of all, we require the sewage sample, which is the source of the bacteriophages. And also we require the host cell. So here I took the E. coli culture. And then the soft agar as well as the hard agar. So already I had prepared the hard agar and I had plated and poured the media into the plate. So along with this one, we require maltose and MgSO4. So these are the requirements. Let us see the how to go with the procedure. So before that, whenever we are incubating the E. coli culture, at that time I had added the MgSO4 and maltose. 50 microliters have been added to the 5 ml LB broth along with the E. coli culture. So this we need to done prior to the experiment, 1 day before, and we need to incubate the culture. So what is the requirement of adding these maltose and MgSO4? As we know that bacteriophages are very specific to their host cell. So here the bacteriophage will adsorb to the specific binding proteins which are present on the surface of the host cell. So specifically the phage will go and bind to the E. coli cells, with these maltose binding protein. Please remember, the phage will go and absorb recognize the maltose binding protein which has been there on the surface of the host cell. So trigger or to activate those maltose binding protein on the surface of the host cell, we need to incubate the E. coli culture along with the maltose and the MgSO4. That is the importance of these two reagents. Okay, now we got the 24 hours culture. And we had filtered the sewage sample also. Now I am taking the soft agar to this. I am adding the E. coli culture to the soft agar. I am adding the E. coli culture. You need to be very quick because the soft agar will solidify. After that, this is the host and now I am adding the sewage sample. Okay. Now mix it properly. To the soft agar, we had added the host cell, that is E. coli, as well as the phage, that is sewage sample. Mix it properly. And then, as I said, already I had poured the media into the plate, the hard agar, and onto this, we will just overlay this soft agar, which is having the phage as well as the E. coli culture. Okay, so on to the surface of the hard agar, we had overlaid the soft agar which is having the host cell along with the phage. Now let it solidify and then you can incubate at 37 degrees centigrade for 24 to 48 hours. So after that you can see the clear zones on the surface of the agar medium which are nothing but the plaques. So as I said, the number of plaques equals to the number of phage particles. I hope it is clear. Thank you.